Well, hey there, team. Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to my review of Mafia Definitive Edition. I've just finished this. I picked it up on a whim because it's out of season. This came out in 2020, so a few years back. However, it does go on deep sale quite often. I've seen it on Steam over the years going on sale, and I keep meaning to get around to it, but, you know, January, at least early January, was quite dry, so I picked up the whole trilogy at deep discount. So if the price is a bit much, which it is pretty steep, if we're being honest, wishlist it. There's a good chance it will go on deep sale in the next few months because it just seems to do that. So it took me 9 hours to get through the campaign. Replayability is limited. This game's not exactly what I would call an open world game. It does have an open world and you can do like a free roam mode, cruise around, you know, cause trouble. But it's definitely not, you know, a Witcher 3. It's definitely not a GTA sort of game. In fact, in a way, I really like the way that it handles that, because this is something that people bring up kind of flippantly, but I think it is a deeper problem indicative of the genre. The idea that, you know, you are probably Witcher 3, for example, dare I criticize that, but you know, you need to save the world. You need to find your lost daughter, that sort of stuff. How is that not a drop everything moment? And yet you do a million side quests cleaning people's frying pans and bullshit like that. It's not necessarily critical of the side quest design, but there is a bit of a dissonance there. And while it's, you know, for the most part memeable and we laugh at it, it does drive the market as well. To the point where we get games like Starfield, which just feels like a padded mess. I'm not necessarily trying to bash Starfield, but imagine if Starfield took the design philosophy of this Mafia game, in that it created a kind of open universe that's kind of empty, that you're not really supposed to go explore, but everything is chapter mission driven. Now, I'm not saying that's how it should be, but just an example of how maybe Starfield could have been a better, tighter, more cohesive experience. Because the beautiful thing about the way Mafia does it, you do have this huge city and there's traffic and there's police and, you know, you can get in chases and that sort of stuff. But generally speaking, you're in a chapter with a mission and something to do. And it's all very peripheral, which adds to immersion for normal people. I'm not talking about Reddit sweatlords with no job that play games for 10,000 hours a day. They're gonna be butthurt that this doesn't have a billion side quests. But for normies, for normal people that play games casually, it's an actual gold star example of how you will be driving around talking to your dude about a mission or whatever, and you can look out the window and you can see the whole open city that's alive, and just it being there and not necessarily going out there and touching it, but knowing that I suppose you could, that's immersion. And most people aren't interested in trying to scrub every square inch for a side mission or trying to break the game. Anyway, I know I'm waffling about that, and I can see that through the eyes of some that this might be a weakness, but I like this design. I like this model. And to go back to my original thought on that is because of the side quest driven magnum opus type Witcher 3-esque games, it drives the market to create these huge open worlds populated with a million side quests, and in a way kind of kills these sort of games, this sort of design, but more importantly, it puts a big question mark over the price point. This game still has cutting edge graphics, design, all the voice work, mocap, the cutscenes, everything is AAA as it gets, and it's still holding up years later. But the argument of, well, it doesn't have 10,000 side quests to keep me busy for 100 hours, makes the goalpost shift, the sort of Overton window over what you should be getting for your money when it comes to AAA. Surely if you're paying a premium price for a premium experience, it's less about volume of content and more about pushing the tech, the genre. This is all food for thought. Anyway, what am I getting at? Ultimately, look, if you're trying to squeeze every penny out of value for money, maybe pass on this game. But if you're someone like me that's not really that worried about throwing money at a good experience, then I would highly recommend this, or at the very least, wishlist it. Look, I got on a little bit of a waffle on open world design, but that's one of the strongest things about this. This game is truly immersive as a period piece. The hours melt away. I was up at 3 a.m. playing it, and I was just having a great time. And this is tragically becoming more and more rare in games. The narrative is solid, though how much of that is owed to the original game? I would have to go back. I played it when it came out. I barely remember it. I'm sort of getting stings of it as I play through this, but a lot of the online discourse is actually quite bitter. I would advise going into the Mafia Reddits and looking all that up, because all it seems to be is a shit canning of this game because it's not the original game, about everything it changed. And as someone who can't really remember the original game, I found this in a vacuum, in a bubble, to be wonderful. The story plays out over a couple of chapters. The gameplay loop, for the most part, is driving around the city. You're not exactly going a million miles an hour, and you can turn a speed limiter on, which I think is quite inspired, so as to cap your car from breaking the speed limit so cops can't pull you over or anything like that, because they will ticket you if you're speeding and start a police chase. On the one hand, I can see this as like an arm behind your back hobbling mechanic that might take away from player agency, but I also see it as something that helps lend to an immersive experience. I'm not saying you have to be a prude that stops at the red lights and behaves yourself 24/7, but if you're ramping your car over rivers and doing just really weird stuff and all that, the player will break their own immersion if you give them the ability to do it. But that's probably for a larger, wider conversation for another time. The story tracks your main dude, Tommy, from his sort of lucky happenstance joining the Mafia, and it is a saga. That's probably worth mentioning. As far as narrative structure goes, it takes course over like a decade, and there's probably a couple dozen chapters or whatever. So it is very vignette-y, episodic in a way. There are some overtures, like with the rival mob gang, but generally speaking, each one is almost like a Monster of the Week episode. But I believe that's the only real way you're going to be able to tell a story that wants to take that bite and not be bloated. It's also probably worth mentioning that I think the runtime of this game is actually really good. I believe if you made it any longer, so as to perhaps justify the price tag, you would run into bloat. It's actually very clean the way it is at the moment. And I suppose going back to that price point, I'm like, well, do you want something that looks like this, feels like this, and goes for this amount of time, the 9 hours, which felt very appropriate and very clean? Well, it's a AAA experience and it's ticked all the boxes. How is full price not the right price? So yeah, look, part of this is just open discussion, a bit of devil's advocate, but I do wonder if our pursuit of trying to get an hour per dollar or some ludicrous thing, you know, just desperately trying to say it should give X gameplay, might actually be pricing out really wonderful, clean experiences because they no longer become competitive. There's some great character work with your sort of cast of characters, but they all backseat to Tommy, the main character. In fact, it's the core story is very much three brothers in arms from its inception to its kind of tragic end. Like, along the way, Tommy has a love interest and family on the side, but it is very much backseat. Dare I say, kind of a masculine heavy story. Not that family is important, but it's more family in the concept as opposed to spending a whole lot of time interacting with his family. It's more about the sort of brothership that he finds himself in. Loyalty to the family, and very much focuses in on like your two side characters as they struggle with, you know, coming up against alcoholism, depression, being worn down by this life. It doesn't go too hard, but there's enough there for development. But yeah, truly my highest praise and the most important takeaway from this is the immersion of this period piece setting and how it just engrosses you for what it is. It takes an appropriate bite of the pie. It doesn't overreach. Again, I don't mean to bash Starfield, but that's a recent one that comes to mind of a game way overreaching what was capable of, and they should have made it 16 times smaller in size and scope, and you would have had a much cleaner experience. This game is, in a word, perfect in what it chooses to bite off and do. So yeah, I highly recommend it, especially if you do find yourself in a bit of a gaming rut, not sure what to play, sort of meandering. This might be just the thing to get you out, because it's kind of gotten me out of it. Anyway, in case you missed it, I think it's a wonderful game, but again, the price point, I spent a lot of time talking about it because in eyes of many, and especially in current year, and all the points that I covered with bloat and extras and this sort of rat race to get value out of your dollar, it might actually be a strong point of contention. So buyer beware. But otherwise, pick your poison, wish list it, pick it up where you think it's right. But you really should play this game. It's quite wonderful. Anyway, team, might just leave it there for the time being, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.